And the topic for this discussion is the future energy landscape. This is something very 17th. Future for energy landscape. The question is little ticklish and difficult because it is based, or it has to be based, on our past experience and evaluation and estimation of the present scenario, what is available on the ground today, and based on that, a scenario to be developed, what it is likely to look tomorrow. In view of today's technical development, economic development, geopolitical development, scientific discoveries, and last but not the least, the disruptive evolution of new technology. Till 5 years back, solar energy was nowhere on the horizon. Its cost was quite prohibitive. During last 5 years, it has been declining and declining to a level that it is bringing the conventional energy at par with the renewable energy. There were initial hiccups in the integration of the renewable energy of solar and wind, mainly because of their intermittent nature, uncertainty, and compatibility with the grid. But this problem is also being overcome today by a combination of the hybrid, that is wind and solar combined, and both being supported by storage. This storage could be a pump storage with a local pondage in hydro, or it could be a battery, or it could be an adjustment of the timings of usage so that the peak in different parts of a country could be staggered to maintain the grid stability. The renewable other sources of energy, like the biofuels, biogas, bio-CNG, bio-LNG, and the ethanol, various shakes of ethanol, they are blending with the liquid fuels, and the use of ethanol in civil aviation, in road transport, and in various other uses where the liquid fuel is required and the renewable may or may not serve the purpose to that extent. With these words, ladies and gentlemen, we begin the session, and I invite first Mr. U. Kumar, Advisor Coal, SL Mining and Industries Limited, to kindly speak.